When you need advice, come to Ben and Kelly. It's group therapy on 99.7 DJX.
I'm going to toss a phone number out real quick, 502-571-9970. Sometimes you just need a little extra opinion on something. Maybe you think, hey, you know what, it doesn't seem right. I'm going to ask Ben and Kelly to toss it out to their listeners and see what they have to say. Well, that's what group therapy is all about. You want to get this one?
Absolutely. Hey, Ben and Kelly, recently went out with someone that I met via a dating app. Seemed amazing. Mm-hmm. We've been seeing each other now for about 6 months. He's a professional with a great career, but that's the issue.
Okay.
Just recently did a simple Google search. It yielded nothing. Huh. My boyfriend claimed to have professional affiliations that should have shown up if the name he gave me was, in fact, his name.
Oh, that's weird.
I gingerly asked what was up. He flipped out, immediately reacted poorly, saying that my research made him feel uncomfortable, like mm-hmm. I didn't trust him, and mm-hmm. was a huge red flag.
Weird.
Now, if this is all fake, I feel so dumb because we've already been intimate. Mm-hmm. I've already introduced him to my parents, and now he's making me feel unreasonable.
Mm.
I think my female intuition is telling me that it's because he's got something to hide. I believe in and trust people, but now I'm questioning things. What do you guys think?
Oh, my gosh. Well, yeah. All right. Well, Kelly, you are can I say, like a trusting female, right?
I'm a very trusting person, yes. I love to give people the benefit of the doubt. Sometimes it takes me a while to figure things out. Can I just point to the enormous amount of red flag emojis that are being posted on our Facebook page right now?
So as a woman, Kelly, are you seeing this situation and going, yeah, red flag?
Well,
or are you saying, well, give him the benefit of the doubt?
Well, no, a lot of people are pointing at his reaction, the way he reacted so strongly as being the biggest red flag in this whole situation. John said, maybe he's a secret government agent. By searching for him by his real name, you might have compromised his job. Ha ha, run.
You know, John has a point. Maybe he does, because I got to be honest, I have a friend who I still, and our entire friend group, we don't know what he does.
Really?
We've known him for 20 years.
And you still don't know his job?
We know he works in Virginia and in Maryland. In Virginia. He works for the government. He works for the government, and, okay. and that's all we know. He works and does things and can't tell us what he does.
Oh, that is, oh, wow.
I know. It's like,
very interesting.
I know,
does
right?
It also make you a little nervous to, like, be his friend? Like, what if, like, you know, stuff goes down and they come after his circle?
I mean, I'm not that close of a friend that I'm going to worry about that, but I'm just saying maybe John, who said that, might like
he's onto something.
Have something. So anyways, let us know, all right, what you think. How much further we really need to go with this group therapy, because the overwhelming responses we're getting. However, because we want to do our due diligence, right?
Uh-huh.
A listener had sent us a message, and she had been dating a guy for 6 months. Some red flags popped up when she Googled his name. Just Googled. What should have come up didn't. In fact, nothing came up, and she's all like, is this a red flag? So she kind of like tossed it over to him, talked to him about it, and he kind of flipped out and was like, that's an invasion. I'm uncomfortable. You're making me feel uncomfortable. It's like you don't trust me, blah, 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 blah.
Right. Well, and now she's even questioning if that's his name. Like, does she know his real name?
That is so,
like,
weird.
Like, that's where we're at. Yeah. And a lot of people are really pointing to the fact that he reacted so defensively.
Right.
And didn't, you know, seem to realize, hey, that's what people do now. Sarah said, well, you already didn't trust him. He didn't respond in a normal way. So I'd say you should nope out that red flag situation like yesterday. No reason to be embarrassed. Play is going to play, honey. Just don't be the one who stays for it.
Uh-huh. You know, Amy brought up a good point. She should be able to just call the company that he says he works at during the day and ask for him on the phone. If they
Very easy thing to do.
No idea what you're talking about, then you have your answer.
Yep.
I mean, a lot of people are saying this is a huge red flag and you just need to, like, hey, it's 6 months. It's 6 months too long. Just cut your losses. And there are a lot of questions also of, like, hey, haven't you ever seen his ID, or haven't you ever, like, been to his place and seen, like, letters and whatever? And who knows? Maybe he hid that stuff from her, you know, and it's like,
yeah,
I'm not thinking of that stuff. If I'm getting into a relationship, like, you know what? I should probably take a look at his ID, or I should probably take a look at her ID.
Yeah, I've never been like a snooping kind of person.
Yeah. And she already said she's kind of a trusting person. So it was like, whatever, you know, it's like, she's just enjoying, you know, the time she's spending with him. So.
Well, John did mention maybe he's like working for like the government, super secret undercover kind of situation. Like, that could be another possibility tossed out. He's married.
Oh, so, yeah. A lot of people.
Either way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Red flags.
Yeah. He's got a second life. All right. So I think we're all saying the same thing. Maybe use this moment to say, Step away. I think it's time that we just start seeing other people. Greg,
we're six months in. You know what? We need a break.
Let's just call it what it is. It was 6 months and go on our way. You know, I think we're all saying that, right?
It's run its course.
Yep. So hopefully that helps, and keep us updated with group therapy.